Hey guys, what's up? Welcome to the Youth Olympic Games here in Lausanne. We're having a good time, we're having a party. We hope wherever you guys are in the world, you're having a good time as well. This, of course, is Yodely. We've got some friends already here. I'm Ash Tullock. We're going to be coming live to you very shortly. This is just a little warm-up. This is just the pre-show. Of course, we're bringing you the fun and flavour of the games, the action. You know where to go now. It's on our website and on our app. We love covering this event. We love meeting athletes like you guys. Hello, what's your name?
Dori.
Dori, where are you from? I should be able to tell from Hungary, yeah?
Yes.
What sport are you doing?
Ice hockey.
Ice hockey. And what about you? Oh, Yodley's got some moves down pat, bit of ice hockey. What about you two? Where are you from?
Hungary also.
And what sport are you doing? Are you ice hockey as well?
No, I've been skiing.
Ah, and how have you been getting on?
Good?
Yeah?
Yeah, it was okay.
Big smiles, big smiles. I believe the slope was fairly difficult. Was it quite icy?
Yeah, it was really icy, but it was nice. It was a great race. Everybody had the same opportunities.
Yeah. I guess that's what it's all about, having a good time and having some fun. Just last, you come in. We don't want to leave you out. What's your name?
Regina.
Regina, where are you from? I'm asking the same question and I know the answer. I'm sorry, you're from Hungary. I keep thinking maybe the Netherlands because it's orange. But what sport are you doing?
Ice hockey.
Cool. And you guys are in the same team?
Yes.
Right. So you're playing, you're doing the 3-on-3?
Yes, yes.
Cool.
And I am the orange team and blue.
Well, all the very best. Great to have you guys with us. Great to have Yodely with us. Yodely, how many friends have you made so far? A lot of friends. This is the Youth Olympic Village. So this is where all the athletes are staying. It is a very, very cool place. We also have got three very special guests who are sitting, waiting backstage. They're going to join us for the party very, very shortly. But we want you guys at home to get involved. We want to know where in the world you're watching from. Yodely, can you point out where your favourite flag is? Can you see a flag that you really like? Okay, that's more than one. That's probably 79. Hey, what are you guys like? Come on over here a little bit more. Can I ask, what are you guys like with your Olympic knowledge? I'm going to say that means you're not so sure. Hey, but look, there is a really cool trivia quiz that is on the Lausanne 2020 website and on the app. Not just yet, after the show, you can jump on there and there are some really cool prizes up for grabs. You can actually win, get this, a trip for two to Tokyo 2020. So maybe it's a good chance to go do some study and do some research. Yeah? Would you like to go to Tokyo?
Yes, of course.
All right, so we'll show you guys where to go after the show. You got to stay with us. We'll give you all the details. We'll give you more details over the next wee while. We have a theme for the show for today. Maybe you guys can tell us who your favorite mascot is. No pressure, but who is your favorite mascot?
Yeah,
I love this. We've got some translation going on behind me. That's fantastic. But you guys at home, tell us, who is your favorite mascot? Yodely, I mean, there's no point in me even asking who your favorite mascot is. If you like Yodely, make sure you send the name Yodely in the comments. Or maybe you like a mascot from the school you go to, or maybe from one of the clubs that you're a part of. Maybe it's an NBA team, maybe it's a football team. See you later, guys. Thanks for joining us. Make sure you send it in. Or maybe it's from a previous Olympic Games, or maybe it is Yodely, just over here. All right, guys, we are having a good time. I think it is about time to start our show. Hopefully we'll get a countdown. We've got a couple minutes before we go in. We've got some volunteers who are around here. Should we come say hello to these guys very quickly? Just quickly, where are you from?
Argentina.
Okay, and where are you from?
Mexico.
And where are you from?
Switzerland, of course.
So amazing. What a cool mix. There's all 3,000 volunteers, people from all around the world, here to help make this games happen. Thank you so much for coming, guys.
You're welcome.
Thank you so much. Now, we have got a poll that we are running. And if I can just look down here, the question is, where will the Winter Youth Olympic Games in 2024 be held? Yodely, can you tell me, do you know where they're going to be held? Right, I think that's a thinking face. Your options are Switzerland, Korea, Norway, or Austria. What do you think? Comment and tell us have a look at that poll and you can get involved. We're going to be revealing the answer a little bit later on. So, Yodley, I just want you to show me again, what is your favourite sport at the Youth Olympic Games? Is it bobsleigh? No, I don't think that's bobsleigh. Is it biathlon? No, I don't think it's biathlon. Yeah, I'm definitely seeing a little bit of alpine skiing there. Fantastic stuff. So can you tell me, did you go see any sport today? And if you did, which sport did you go and see? Ah, the ice hockey. I feel like you just hit me with the puck there, so thank you very much for that. It's okay. It's all right. Of course, the ice hockey is a very special event here. There's a three-on-three competition where they have mixed national Olympic committees. So you've got people from Australia, people from Trinidad and Tobago. You've got athletes from all around the world playing together. Wonderful stuff, yeah? How good, how good. Take a little look around. I just want you to have a look at some of these flags. It's probably a little bit hard to see how beautiful this place really is. It's quite marvellous. Every night we get to enjoy it, and it really is, well, it's quite breathtaking. But we're going to head inside. It's time to get the show underway, and we want you guys to join us. Make sure you do stay with us. We've got some special guests. We're going to have some fun. Looking forward to having you on the show very, very shortly. We're going to get that countdown. We're going to come to you in a few moments. Hello, what's up, guys? Welcome to the Youth Olympic Village. We are here in Lausanne, Switzerland for the Youth Olympic Games. Almost 2,000 athletes are competing. They're giving it their all, and we are so happy to be bringing this to you wherever you are in the world. Of course, if you want to see the action, hello, guys, how's it going? It's people walking past, people coming in and out, depending on what they've been doing for the day. And if you want to watch the action, if you want to see what has been going down, make sure you join us on olympicchannel.com or on our op. You can follow us, of course, on social media. We're on the slopes, we're on the luge, we're everywhere. And right now, we are, of course, inside the Youth Olympic Village. A few athletes coming in and out, and also a very special friend. If you haven't met this special character, this is Yodley, the mascot for Lausanne 2020, who seems to be having a very good time. How much fun have you been having here? I feel like you are probably one of the fittest people here, the amount of jumping up and down that you have to do, and a lot of free hugs that you've been giving out. Yodley, the mascot, of course, is a very special part of these games. Now, we want you guys at home to tell us where you are watching from. So if you've got a little space in front of you, write it down and you can tell us. I've already got some messages. Frankie Jr. is watching from Australia. Sebastian J. is watching from Argentina. Great to have you guys watching with us. And we, of course, as I mentioned, if you were watching our pre-show, have got a poll that we are doing today. And the poll that we are doing is, where will the Winter Youth Olympics be held in 2024? The options are Switzerland, Korea, Norway, or Austria. Get your thinking caps on and make sure that you try and answer that poll for us. Of course, it's not just Yodley and I that are going to be on the show. We've got some very special guests. Let's go see who's waiting in the green room. Kikkan, Randall, Marie-Laure, Brunet, and gold medal winner in the figure skating, Yu Young. Why don't you come on down and join us down here? All right, guys, give it up. Give up a big round of applause. Yu is going to be coming down and joining us on the show very, very shortly. So let's see when she comes out. I've already spoken to these guys, but before she comes down, maybe we can just say, where are you from?
I'm from Switzerland.
So you're here to enjoy the show. Oh, and she's coming on down, so we will give her a big round of applause. Yu Young has come to say hello. And we'll give you a big hug. Hello, how are you? I've been running around with two microphones, but that, in fact, is for you.
Thank you.
Hey, look, you have a very beautiful special medal around your neck. Congratulations on winning that gold yesterday.
Thank you.
How did you celebrate?
Well,
I celebrated with my roommates last night. We play a lot, like we talk and chat and we eat a lot of food and yeah.
Is it quite nice because once you've finished competition, that means you can actually stay up a little bit later and you can probably have some, you know, other treats. Did you have a nice dinner? Did you treat yourself?
Yeah, we stayed a whole night and...
You stayed up all night?
Yeah.
That sounds like a very good time.
Yeah, because I just don't want to miss tonight, like last night.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, I can imagine. It's a very special moment.
Yeah.
Did you see Yodley? Has Yodley been around the figure skating at the competition you've been there?
I saw him dancing.
Yeah. Yodley very much likes dancing. Yodley is just over there high-fiving all of the volunteers. Hey, look, we are going to go inside. We're going to leave Yodley outside to spend some time with some other athletes. But we are going to have a quick look at some of the special moments from your routines. So let's have a look at that, and we're going to head on inside.
Yu Jung from Korea. Love the way she came out with that focus and energy into the double axel, then so much speed and confidence into the combination. And she makes it. 3.5 turns, cleanly done. Well, that was a dream of a skate for Yu Jung of Korea. Just unbelievable.
Wow. Amazing. I mean, truly, the look on your face was just, you just look relieved. How did it feel in that moment for you?
I feel really happy because I did my clean program in the Youth Olympics, and it's a really big competition because it's Olympics, right?
Yeah.
So I was really happy after the competition, and yeah.
Have you had a chance to watch it back yet? Other than what you just saw, have you seen your routines?
Yeah, I saw it in YouTube of Olympic channel of my videos.
Very good, we love that. Hey look, if you guys at home have got any questions for Yu Jung, make sure you send them in because I'm sure you would love to hear from everyone who's watching at home, right? I want to know, before you came here, you were competing at the Korean Nationals, you won your fourth title. The first one you won, you were 11 years old. So you won your fourth title just before coming here. You hopped on the plane. How did you manage to hop on that long, long flight and then turn up here and deliver a gold medal winning performance?
I try to feel more, this is more like a practice because I was really tired after the nationals, so I tried to be, I can do mistakes like more comfortable, so I think that makes me do more better skates in here.
I feel like you deserve to just sleep for the next wee while. Just to catch up on that.
Yeah.
I wanted to know, but when do you start thinking about Beijing 2022?
That was my big dreams when I was young. I was dreaming about that when I was like almost 10, because I always imagine in Beijing 2022 Olympics, and I want to perform there, and also I want to have gold medal, but if I have a chance, I really want to be in that stage.
Yeah, so that's already sort of the next thing going through your mind. And you've already got one Youth Olympic medal. Actually, can you hold that up? Can you just show the camera there? It really is something special. And we were saying the other day that they're much heavier than what people realize, aren't they?
It's very special because, like, it's like very
shiny.
Goldy and shiny.
Hey, I want to ask you if it's okay. We want to have a look at your routine from last night. Are you able to talk me through what you were thinking through the routine?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, okay. So let's have a look at this screen just here. This, of course, is the routine that helped Yu Jung win Youth Olympic gold. So what are you, I mean, that is your opening triple axel. How happy were you to actually get that and land cleanly?
Actually, before I was jumping triple axel, I didn't thought I would land it, but I land it and I feel like, oh, wow. And I just think the next routine.
And then, I mean, looking at you here, you just look very calm. Your face just looks very relaxed. I mean, I feel like most people would be panicking at that moment, but you look very calm. How are you feeling inside when you're performing?
Because sometimes if I get too happy, I get mistakes. So I'm trying to be like calm down a bit. And that makes me more concentrated in the program.
I feel like, so your music selection is very important, isn't it? Because if you were performing to, I don't know, something like The Lion King, it might make you like really happy.
Yeah.
And what about here? When you're getting to the end of your routine, do you start feeling like I'm almost there? I've almost sort of got to the end. Is there a sense of relief when you finish?
Yeah, I think like, oh my God, it's like really done. Because before my long program, I was kind of nervous because it's my last skate and I think I did really much better than I thought, and I feel really relieved after my free program.
Well, it's truly so wonderful to have you here because you are one of the stars of these games. And it really, I don't laugh, it's true, it really is
okay.
And it's so nice to be able to see how much you love figure skating because, boy oh boy, you're very good at it.
Thank you.
Hey, look, the next Winter Youth Olympics are coming up in a couple of years and we have a poll. In 2024, who is going to be, don't answer because I think that you know the answer.
Okay, yeah.
So you guys at home can try and fill in the blank. Who do you think it is? We'll tell you later. We'll just leave it there. Maybe you is a clue, but we'll leave it for now. Hey, look, something that is very important to figure skaters is the Zambonis. If you don't know what a Zamboni is, well, you're going to find out right now. Take a look at this. MD from the Lowdown has been on a Zamboni.
Hi guys, it's MD. We're at the figure skating venue of Lausanne 2020. It's where all the magic happens. We're with Kevin. He's the ice master and responsible for making sure this ice looks perfect. He's been doing it for 8 years. So Kevin, can you run us through how the machine works?
Je vais vous expliquer le fonctionnement d'une machine qui est une surfaceuse à glace. Ici, vous avez une lame qui va couper la neige et après, il y a des vis sans fin qui amènent la neige dans la benne. Derrière, nous avons une panneuse qui dépose l'eau sur la glace pour compenser ce que nous avons coupé. Voilà, merci.
How very special. I mean, that is such an important job, isn't it? Because if the ice isn't right and if it isn't perfect, do you notice that? Can you feel it underneath?
Yeah, because a lot of skaters are very hard to do in a very rough ice. So Zamboni is a really good job to make the ice very smooth so we can jump more better and easier. So I think it's the most important thing is in ice. And ice temperature and how it feels like, it makes a really big difference if it's bad.
Have you sat on one before, like MD? Have you ever ridden on one?
No. No.
Hey, look, we've got some questions that have been coming in. April wants to know, what's the next jump you want to try in competitions after the 3A?
You mean 3A is triple axel?
The triple axel, yeah. There's all these code words with figure skating. It's quite tricky. Mm-hmm. These sort of codes for the judging and whatnot. But the question there, what is the next jump you want to try in competitions after the triple axel?
Because now a lot of skaters are doing triple axels. And the Russian skater, of course, they're doing quads. So my planning is, it was before my planning too when I was young, was doing my quads in the competition and landed in competitions, but I'm really trying to land it in practice first.
Yeah.
And it's really rough.
There's one thing I really, really just quickly want to ask you, and that is when you are off the ice, because you spend so much time on the ice, but when you're off the ice, what do you like to do?
Can I say this? Like, I really like BTS. It's a singer, and they're really famous. And I also like Ariana Grande, and she's a very good singer too. I always like listen to their music when I'm very sad or I'm tired, and sometimes I just dance by myself in like the mirror, and yeah, it helps when I'm tired.
Will you ever dance to Ariana Grande as a part of a routine? Do you think your coach will let you do that?
Not of hers dancing, but I'm trying to sing her songs these days, but it's really hard because her voice is very special.
Amazing. Thank you so much. Hey, we're going to have a little look now at some of the action from today. The last medals in the ski mountaineering, which of course is the new sport, the one new sport happening here at Lausanne. So let's have a look and celebrate these wonderful achievements. Have you had a chance to see any of the other sports yet, like ski mountaineering?
Not really, but I always cheer my teammates in a live show, in a live video.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, that's good. I mean, you've been so busy focused on what you're doing, so haven't had a chance to see other sports, but maybe after this you'll be able to do that. Hey, guys, I'm really excited because we're going to bring down another guest. We introduced you just a little bit before. She is such an inspiration. Can we give a big round of applause to Kikkan Randall? Come on down. Kikkan, you young?
Yes.
So good to have both of you on the couch. Look at this. This
nice
is
hardware
you.
There. That's pretty cool.
This is you. Well, we just missed the shot that just went off the screen, but I'm sure you've seen it before. You winning that gold medal in Pyeongchang. What is it like when you see those moments, I guess, of just only a couple of years ago of you on top of the world?
Well, it's so good we have it documented on film because sometimes it feels like a dream.
Yeah.
I mean, I remember those moments so clearly, but it just, everything clicked together. And in the last race of my Olympic career, and what I love about it is I get to be back in that moment with my teammates and that memory.
Yeah, and I guess that's the thing that you can impart knowledge to athletes like you, is that this is a really remarkable experience, isn't it? It is a once in a lifetime opportunity. So I guess, have you had a chance to sort of talk to athletes like you and say, savor this moment?
Yeah, I mean, this is so cool because we can all picture ourselves back in your shoes, and you're at the start of your journey. And it's so incredible to be here where you get to meet athletes from other country at the start of your journey. And these may become lifelong friends, and these are memories that will inspire you and carry you through a career, hopefully to that Olympic gold medal someday.
Now, if you don't know Kikkan's story, you were on top of the world after several world championship medals. It was the next step, you know, at Pyeongchang, getting that gold. And then, of course, you were diagnosed with cancer. And then you've come out the other side. You're a fighter. You're a survivor. That truly is a remarkable, remarkable journey. And for you to be here today, for you to be able to share your story and your experience with these athletes, I mean, that is a really powerful thing. Do you feel that? Do you know that you're able to really inspire such an amazing, create some belief in these athletes through your story?
Well, I think what's really unique about it is that as veteran athletes, we like to, of course, talk about the value of sport and all the great things it will do in your life. But in having to take those same skills and experiences and use it to get through a challenge like cancer, where you don't have as much control, but it's the same things are important. It's about having that positive mindset. It's about having a great team of people around you. And I think that hopefully allows me to come and pass that message on with a little bit more confidence and enthusiasm. And again, it's amazing how the Olympics can inspire in so many ways. It's not just for elite athletes. It's for everyone to be at their best in the world.
Yeah, it's great that, you know, you're able to share that message, and athletes like you are able to sort of be a part of this journey. You know, your journey is not over. You're still inspiring, and yet you're still giving back to all sport, which is so great. Now, as a skier, you will know how important it is to have your skis in good working order. Just like we were talking before with the figure skating rink, it's so important to have the rink perfect. When you're skiing, it's important to have your skis in perfect condition. And we have been out and about and finding out exactly what you need to have the right preparation for your skis. Have a look at this.
Hi, ski preparation is key to go fast on the slopes. Let's see how the process works. We are here with Coach Sean from Team US. So Sean, can you tell us, can you explain how the process works?
Yeah, absolutely. There are a few simple steps. Three in particular. The first step is to sharpen the skis so the skis hold well on the ice that you have up there, as you can see Rufo doing right now. The second step is to roll wax onto the base of the ski, which helps the ski glide over the snow. It also protects the base. And Rufo can show you how to roll the wax onto the ski right now. Then the third and final step is to actually scrape the wax off of the ski and then brush the wax out of the structure of the base, which you can see Rufo doing here. These are the three basic steps to ski preparation.
Wow. I didn't realize that there was that much that needed to be done. Do you have to do anything like that with your skates?
Yes, we always need to like sharpen it because it could be very soft if we use it a long time.
Yeah. Yeah, everything has to be perfect. Everything's got to be sharp. Yeah. It's very dangerous. We've got one more space on the sofa, so let's go to the green room and bring on down Marie-Laure Brunet, who is waiting to come and join us. So why don't you come on down and come join us on the sofa, two-time Olympian in biathlon. Yeah, so good to see you. You've got Kikkan, and the pictures of you here. Honestly, I just can't get over it. Can you, when you watch this, how does it feel?
It's still a lot of emotion because, you know, when you catch a medal in the Olympic Games, it's so amazing. And yeah, it's far, but I'm so happy to see this, this video.
I want to ask you a little bit more when it comes to biathlon. It's a combination of cross-country skiing and shooting, so it's a lot of different things kind of happening all at once. So how do you manage to get your heart rate up so high when you're racing and then calm and focused when you need to be shooting?
Yeah, that's exactly like this. Yeah, in biathlon, when you are on the track, you are supposed to be really fast. And to think to be the best on the track. But when you arrive on the shooting range, it's really important to switch your brain and just calm, be focused, and just think about technical point to put the bullets on the target. So it seems really easy like this, but it's not.
It's very difficult, and I was talking to you about it just before, and you were saying you have to do the same thing when you're going up for the various elements in your routine. You kind of have to be, you're quite tense, and then you have to relax, don't you?
Yeah, because we have seven kind of jumps in the long program, and when we like fall in the first jump, we'll be like very high. So we need to come down for the next jump if we don't make mistakes.
I don't know. I honestly just don't know how you do it. But when we look at you and you're here and you're speaking with these athletes and you're giving them advice, what is the main piece of advice that you've been giving them from your Olympic experience?
I try to explain them, especially to the biathletes. They are here to take a lot of experience, and it's also really important to share with other athletes and other nations, because this is for them. So after, when they will be in the room, in the true Olympic Games, the biggest, it will be a bit different. But all the experience they live here will help them for the next step. So I think it's a really good adventure for them to be here.
Yeah, and it's not just about the sport, it's about, I guess, connecting with different people from different countries, the cultural diversity, and also there's a program here where the athletes can take a camera and then they can go out and they can do some filming, do some of their own interviewing, and then they can edit it. And we've got a video here, it's our Olympic moment of the day, so the moment that we've picked out is something a little bit special, and it is the Slovenian biathletes, actually. So let's have a look at what they're like at filming and editing.
Mm-hmm. Come on.
We are here today for the single mixture race. Enjoy.
Hi, my name is Lina and I'm biathlete from Slovenia.
I'm also from Slovenia. My name is Mark and this is our mascot Fox.
Everyone starts dancing in the background. As soon as the music stops, everyone stops dancing. That song we have heard so much, but it's so good. It feels good. It feels good to hear it, doesn't it?
Oh, it's a great anthem to be playing in your mind constantly. I mean, start now. It's never too late to start now.
Well, speaking of starting now, I'm actually going to throw you in the deep end. We've got a chair sitting there, and we're going to do some quick-fire interrogation questions with you. Are you up for this?
I'm ready.
All right. Always a competitor, right? Once a competitor, always a competitor. So you jump up there. We are going to fire a few questions. Let me see. All right, guys. Are we ready? So we're going to get you to look at this camera just there. You can see us. Dun, dun, dun. Heart is racing. All right, the first question, Kikkan. If you have friends coming for dinner, what would you cook?
Well, despite the fact that it's actually from Mexico, we love our Mexican food in the U.S., and so that's always something I love to cook when my friends come.
Do you snore?
Not that I know of, but I'm a super hard sleeper, so you're going to have to ask my roommates.
Do you have a party trick?
If there's a unicycle around, I'd love to do a lap.
Exploring a city or lazing on the beach, which would you prefer?
Definitely getting out and exploring a city.
If your friends compared you to an animal, which animal would it be?
I think the snow leopard, because that's where I'm most comfortable, in the snow.
All right, and the last question is, what is your dream job?
My dream job is being at the Youth Olympics and motivating the athletes to chase their dreams.
Woo! All right, Key, can you come on down? All right, you. Can you do this? Are you ready for one more competition? We're going to get you to go on the interrogation chair. You ready?
Okay.
Okay, let's do it. All right, give it up for you. She's already got one Youth Olympic gold medal. Can she win another? I don't think I have the ability to give out one of those, so I'm very sorry. I think I'll be able to give you Olympic Channel beanie. Is that all right?
Yeah.
Yep, okay. So you look down the camera, see where it says camera 5. Kike, give you a big wave. Give way. Yep, cameraman Kike. Oh, yeah, we're good. All right. Okay, so the first question is, where are you from?
I'm from South Korea.
What is your favorite color?
There's too much. I like yellow.
Have you ever been told that you look like someone famous?
Not really, but I heard someone, I look like a Korean actress.
Ah, if someone could play you in a movie, who would you like that person to be?
Maybe a handsome man. I don't know.
That would make things very amusing. Well yeah. done, you. Come on down. Come sit down. Well done, guys. Thank you very much. Don't worry, I'm going to leave you alone. I feel like we've done enough interrogating for the day. I feel a little bit rude. Sorry, guys. But hey, look, thank you so much for joining me. Just quickly, which sport are you going to go watch tomorrow?
Biathlon.
Of course. And for you?
Biathlon.
Biathlon. And which sport are you going to go watch?
I like watching figure skating, of course, but I like biathlon too.
All right, we're all going to go watch some biathlon. Hey! All right, guys, let's have a look at our poll because we have been asking you where the Winter Youth Olympics will be hosted in 2024, and the answer is Korea. So it's going to be good. It's going to be a good time. Thank you guys so much for joining me on the sofa. It's been a pleasure. We really enjoy having you. Yodlee's in the corner. Thank you, Yodlee. You guys at home, jump on the trivia quiz, Lausanne 2020. It's on the app. It's on the website. You can win tickets to Tokyo. So make sure you jump on there. See you tomorrow.